have we had personal struggles? This is family and friends. Yeah. In your family, in your personal family, yeah. I can think back through my own family when we had to go through this event, yeah. when we had to cry through this, right. when we had to moan, when we had to put our head down. Ooh. Struggle, struggle, struggle. We had to go through a struggle. What is a struggle? A struggle is something that's perceived to be very hard and difficult. It's a hard task, something that you really have to really endure and try hard to get through. It's not something that you can play with. It's not a daydream. It's not a dream. It's not a figment of your imagination. It's not a mirage. It's not an illusion. It's not a fairy tale. The struggle that you're going through is real. And we all have struggles.
Yes,
struggles after struggles. This is what life is. We struggle trying to be perfect. We struggle with materialism. We struggle not having the right answers.
Yes.
We struggle not understanding the Bible.
Yes.
We struggle with busyness.
Yes.
We struggle with our non-Christian family and friends.
Yes.
We struggle sharing our faith. We struggle spending time with God. We struggle the way folks talk about us, the way folks think about us.
Yes.
We struggle living out our faith. We struggle living in an anti-Christian culture.
Yes.
We struggle with negative media issues. We struggle with our self-image.
Yes.
We struggle with absent father figures.
Yes.
We struggle with lack of discipline. We struggle with educational goals. We struggle with our careers. We struggle with our jobs. And the list can go on and on and on and on.
Yes.
Why? Because life is filled with struggles.
Yes.
Everyone has struggles. What about Bill Gates? Bill Gates failed in his first company. Richard Branson, the actor, was a terrible student and still suffers with dyslexia.
Huh.
Albert Einstein was the father of modern physics, but he was rejected from college.
Yeah.
James Dyson, yes, he finally had a vacuum cleaner that works, but he failed it 5,127 times before he got this one to work. What about Steve Jobs? He was kicked out of his own company because he kept having failed projects and spent too much money. What about Chris Carr? She turned cancer into an opportunity. What about Tyler Perry? He was homeless and penniless. What about Stephen King? He was broke and poor. What about Jim Carrey, the actor? At the age of 15, he had to drop out of school because his father couldn't keep a job and he had to get a job to support his family. What about Oprah Winfrey? Her mother was a teenager from a low-income family living in conditions that were rough. She was sexually abused starting at the age of 9 by her cousin, uncle, husband, and family. At the age of 15, she was pregnant and lost a child. What about Jay-Z? He had talent, but nobody wanted to give him a record deal. What about J.K. Rowling, the author of Harry Potter? She started in 1990 writing, but when she started writing, her mother got sick with multiple sclerosis. She got married in 92. Her mother died. She was divorced by 93. She had a child. She was a failure. She was jobless. She was divorced. She had she was dependent upon the government system. That was the lady that wrote Harry Potter. Because thus she went through a struggle. What about Bill Gates? He failed in his first company. What about Henry Ford? He had three companies before he fell and figured out the fourth company. Three. He failed in one. He struggled through. He struggled through three. What about Colonel Sanders? We all know Colonel Sanders. At the age of 62 with a $105 check, Social Security check in his pocket, he said, "I'm going to start a restaurant." Over 1,000 folks told him he was crazy. But what do we see today?
Kentucky Fried Chicken.
All over the country. But he had a struggle getting to where he really needed to go. What about Jonah in the Bible? When we think about Jonah, all we want to talk about is the well. But you want to know how Jonah got in the well. Jonah got in the well because he was struggling doing what God told him to do. He didn't want to obey God. And when you don't want to obey God, it's a struggle.
Yeah.
And that's what Jonah did.
Yeah.
What about Job? Job suffered through great loss, devastation, and physical illness. He lost everything. child, wealth, and his health. Job said in Job 3:3, I wish I had died in my mother's womb. I have no peace, no rest. My troubles never end. I am tired of living. Listen to my bitter complaint. I am overcome with terror. My dignity is gone like a puff of wind, and my prosperity like a cloud. Now I'm about to die. There is no relief for my struggle. At night, my bones ache, and pain never stops. Saints, that's a struggle. What about Moses? Moses was grieved over the sins of the people. He felt angry. He felt betrayed by his own people. When Moses came down with the Ten Commandments, Moses thought the church was waiting for him. Moses just knew they were sitting down there waiting for the pastor to come back. He just knew they are coming back for me, and they're waiting. But when Moses got back, what happened? I ain't talking about y'all from California. The preacher that Moses left in charge. Turned into a calf. Well, yeah, okay. I'm still trying to figure out how you just poured it in and it jumped out a calf. Wow. See, that's how sin does it. It makes us sound real stupid. You know, I just don't know how it happened. I just don't know what I did. I don't know how I got over here. I don't know how they got me. You know how you got there. You know how you got there. But all of a sudden, that bone jumped out like a calf. Well, praise the Lord. So when Moses got back and found that the folks had did everything but right, Moses was upset. He was struggling because he thought he had the folks a little farther than where they should have been. He thought that they knew how to pray. He thought they knew God. He thought they knew how to worship God. He thought that they loved God. But when Moses got down there, he said it's almost as bad as it was before we came over God. So that was a struggle for Moses. Was messed up. He was going through a struggle. What about David? David said, I'm distressed in my loneliness, fear of the enemy. His heart cried over sin. He struggled with guilt from his own sin. That's why. When the enemy gets through with you, when the enemy takes you upside down, turns you around, then he wants to put a guilt trip in your head. He wants you to always remember what you did, who you did it with, how long you were there. Why you were there? That's the job of the enemy. The enemy is there to steal and to destroy. He doesn't want you to get up. He doesn't want you to get over. He doesn't want you to give God praise. He doesn't want you to clap your hands. He doesn't want you to tell thank you. So when the people didn't do this, David was distressed. David was in trouble. David struggled. David said, I am drowning in the flood of my sins. They are burdens too heavy to bear. A struggle. Life is a struggle. It's just not other folks in the world. It's church folks that are struggling. What about Elijah? Elijah was discouraged. He was weary and afraid. I have had enough, Lord, he said. Take my life. I am not better than my ancestors. What about Jeremiah? Jeremiah, he was the prophet that told the folks, you go on ahead. He told the folks you live in wrong. He told the folks that you need to get saved. He told the folks you need to be delivered. He told the folks that you need to turn around. And when Jeremiah told them, they got mad. They got angry. They pushed him out. They made him an outcast. He was a weary ground. He was weary. He was struggling. He was sad. He was burdened. He had no wife. He had no family. He had no children. He had no money. He was a poor broker. your dignity, your beauty, make us take notice of him. There was nothing that would draw us to him. No one would even look upon him. That's the man that we don't want, but that's the man we need. We're not looking for a moving star. We're not looking for the prime thing. But who we need to look for is Jesus. Our text today is about a woman. The woman who had an issue of blood. She spent all that she had. I don't need you to know. I don't need to tell you about it because you know all about it. You know her struggle. Some of you have struggled with health. Some of you have lost your money. Some of you have paid everything trying to get better. Going to this doctor. Going to this doctor. But one day she heard about Jesus. And the thing that you say, that's why we got to talk about Jesus. That's why we got to tell folks about Jesus. Because somebody is looking. Somebody is trying to hear what we're saying about Jesus. Why? She heard that he healed the sick. She heard that he raised the dead. She heard that he opened blind eyes. She heard that he fell 5 times. She heard that he walked on water. She heard that he turned water into wine. She heard that he calmed the angry sea. She heard that he restored sight. She heard that he raised the dead. She heard that Jesus came. Jesus delivers and Jesus sets free. Well, she said, if I can but just touch the hem of his garment. Oh my God. She heard. To get to Jesus. She had to make her way through the crowd. She had to get through something to get to Jesus. Just because you want to be saved does not mean that everything is going to be alright. It doesn't mean that every door is going to open for you. It doesn't mean that everybody's going to like you. It doesn't mean that everybody's going to welcome you in. But if you want to connect to Jesus, you're going to have to do something to get to Jesus. You're going to have to cross your way. We're here to praise God.
ever get to Jesus? Did she get to him? All of that struggle. She didn't stop until she touched him. Did she touch him? And when she touched him, everything that was wrong was laid right. I think the gospel writer said immediately the hemorrhage dried up. And Jesus said, your faith has made you whole. Ooh, Sister Macklin. Of the service. Coming to the conclusion.